All right, time to start working on the five here. Now, for me, I know you say you hate the Rolling Stones, but I'm going to give you these songs, Spank, that maybe you can get into. I'm going to go out of my way not to overly go deep on this.
Thank you for that.
I don't want to be, you know, Far Away Eyes and fucking Loving Cup and Sweet Virginia, which really might, those songs might make my own personal. But I want to do an introduction five to you.
That's right.
And even that is very, very hard. I might look at some of the greatest rock and roll songs of all time and not put them on the list. One song that I said is the greatest radio song of all time may not make my list.
That's scary.
All right, let's start it off with Can You Hear Me Knocking? Listen to this. That comes in, I guess, as my number five. Now, this is actually a lot tougher to pull off a five for the Rolling Stones. Jeff, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Loving Cup, Ron.
You know, I love the song, but am I going to give that to people who, like a Spanky Frank, who's all about the Beatles and not about the Stones? Could you please not confuse the five? Thank you. Thank you. We're not into the. We're not going to play a 15. It's got to be the five today.
Just Ron's five.
Steve, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie, Steve from the Water Gap. You got to include Happy. Keith Richards lead vocal. You know, everybody hears Mick Jagger, but that is an awesome song. And it's, you know what? While I was on hold, I think Happy's got to be up there too.
I know. I understand that what you're saying. I know it's the song that, you know, Mick can go take a piss while it's going on. It's a great fucking tune. I don't want to make it part of my five, though. This is very, very important to me.
There's only five.
866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. There are a couple of classic songs that will not make my five. That's the problem you have when you're fucking with the Rolling Stones.
You're excluding a lot. Sure.
Let's go with my number four.
Did you ever wake up to a night, a day that broke up your mind, destroying your notion of circular time? It's just that demon.
That's the Rolling Stones' five list. And you know what's really kind of weird when I go back over this? You don't really have a lot of Rolling Stones songs that remind you of not doing bad things. You really think of, oh, yeah, this was the darkest.
It's some fucking down dirty music, man. It's great.
I don't think that they did it on purpose. Buck, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Mahabone.
Yeah.
I hate to stay with 70 Stones, but Monkey Man's got to be on my list.
First of all, I don't ever want you to worry about the late 60s, early 70s Stones, because that's going to play the largest part of it for me as well. Monkey Man just did not make my five. Barely. If we did this tomorrow, I might fucking switch it out. With Can't Hear Me Knocking. I might do it.
Who knows? This is today's five.
All right. Stabman, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ron.
Yeah.
Not really one of the hits, but I'm thinking Moonlight Mile. I love that song.
I love that fucking song, Beyond Life. If I was making it personal, yeah, I'm sure Sweet Virginia would be on there. I'm sure Far Away Eyes would be on there. I think Moonlight Mile would be on there. But I'm trying to turn the kid on at the same time. Tune, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, one of my all-time favorite classics of all time from the Rolling Stones is Under My Thumb.
It's such a great fucking song. It should be on my list, and it is not. It's one of those songs that when you haven't heard for a long time, and then you put it on, you go, holy shit. I thought this was my 28th favorite fucking Stone song, but it's not.
I do this a lot. I make, like, mix CDs, or I used to, and I have some that I have back in high school that I made, and every so often I'll go back and listen to that old music, and I'll forget all that music that I put on the album, and I'll be like, wow, this is such great music, whatever.
Well, what was the song that you forgot that you put on a mix CD for yourself?
I'm trying to think. It's some, you know, it's going to sound real crazy.
All the stuff was about dialysis, like a lot of dialysis fucking stuff.
No, that was all sad music. I'm just trying to think, like...
Like, give me a kidney, or can someone help me? I really, seriously, I think my fucking blood count is low.
But stuff like Sweet Home Alabama, I used to put on like all my old mix CDs.
So you really go deep. Rhino, you're on Runafest.
Yeah, it's so hard to choose from, you know, you go earlier, you go later, but I would love Tumbling Dice or It's All Over Now. One of, you know, two different times.
Both great songs. Both should fucking be there. Did not make my five. Did not make my quick put together five. Chris, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ron, how about a little Tickling of the Ivories with She's a Rainbow?
You know, if we're going to go deep, sure. Yeah, I will too. I will too. But no, not today. Let's go to my number three. And sometimes in my life, this is my number one. Some people think it's about Vietnam. I think it's about dope sickness. And I'm talking Give Me Shelter. Give Me Shelter. Listen to this fucking song. Listen to it with fresh ears. It's Give Me Shelter, number three on my five. Let me ask you this about your beloved Beatles. You think they could have thrown the fucking term rape, murder? It's just a shot away into a song. Come on.
That's just ridiculous. Well, you know what?
Who would have done that? The Ringo? Fucking Octopus is a Garden?
Well, let me put it this way. The Rolling Stones are a much different band than the Beatles. Hands down. The Rolling Stones are a blues band. Hands down. Beatles are, as much as it hurts me to say this, they're a pop band.
They are a pop band, and it shouldn't hurt you. There's nothing wrong with being a pop band, but they are a pop band. But the Rolling Stones are the fucking rock and roll band, whether you like it or not. And if you were putting together the all-star team of bands, you've got to have Mick as the front man. You don't fucking get out of that. And how could you not have fucking Keith in your band? He's in your fucking band if you're putting together an all-star band. Now, having said that, can you keep John Lennon and Paul McCartney out of your all-star band? You may be looking, you might be fucking looking at those four guys in your all-stars.
I would at least want John and Paul to write the songs that you were going to write, that you were going to play for the band.
I don't know. I'll sit there and debate the fact that that song might be more of a favorite song to me than anything the Beatles have ever done that I just did. Let's go over to my number two. And it isn't even there for me right now, but at other times of my life. By the way, you said you had something to add about me saying that was a dope sex song.
Yeah, well, I read Keith's book, his memoir, and he
said... I didn't read it. Is it good?
It's actually pretty good. It's really well written.
What did you do? Bring it in for me to read today?
I could bring it in if you'd like.
Then you didn't.
I didn't know we were going to be doing a top five today. Otherwise,
well, always think.
I have Fear and Loathing. You want to read that again?
No, I'm fine.
Okay. But one, when he was recovering, one of the times that he was recovering from dope sickness, he was writing songs, and he saw actually a storm rolling in over the clouds, and that's how he got his inspiration for Gimme Shelter.
Well, why did then other people say it's about fucking numb?
Because they twist things around. Everyone's all... I mean, there's many songs that like can mean one thing to one person.
I know.
Completely different to the
songwriter.
Well,
to me, it's a dope sex song, and it's perfect. It should have been my number one. I don't know what the fuck I did. Let's move into my number two. I said other times in my life, this has been my number one. Covered by Dave's all-time favorite band. Lesser, by the way. Guns N' Roses covered this. There's only these guys for me, the Stones, doing this version. Oh, Jane's Addiction also covered it. But the Rolling Stones, Sympathy for the Devil.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his face. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was a time for a change. Killed the Tsar and his ministers. Anastasia screamed in vain. I rode a tank, held a generous rank. When the blitzkrieg raged and the bodies stank. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guess my name. Oh yeah, I was puzzling you with the nature of my game. Oh yeah, I watched with glee while your kings and queens fought for tender case for the gods they made. I shouted out, "Who killed the Kennedys?" When after all, it was you and me. Let me please.
Hicks, I saw you fucking getting the voodoo child over there. You digging it?
Love it. Can't get enough of this shit.
It's weird because I'm a little disconnected from this song right now, but I couldn't let it down. That was four of my five. Trying to turn Spanky Frank out of his fucking love of the fucking Beatles, a constant lifetime love of the Beatles.
Never.
And maybe pay a little attention to the Stones. Brian, what do you got?
Hey, guys. You were saying about John and Paul writing for you. You know, I'd really like Nanker Felge writing for me. Hmm. I might go a little deep here, but my favorite would be Let It Bleed.
Love the song. Love the song. Alex, you're on Ron and Fez.
Mookie House?
Yeah.
How about this one? I'll never be your beast of burden.
Thanks. Eric, you're on the Ron and Fez show. Hey.
Check it. A great underrated Stone song. I know it's deep, but time waits for no one. Great. Mick Taylor's guitar solo. You could tell he was just listening to tons of Santana. It is just gorgeous. It'll make the hairs on your neck raise up. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's amazing. And the Mick Taylor years, phenomenal. Just phenomenal. Well, you might say to yourself, Ron, I've heard you talk so many times how you said Jumpin' Jack Flash is the best radio song of all time. It is. Hands down.
It's really tough to beat that.
And it didn't make my top five.
I'm very interested to see what's the number one.
Shut out.
I want to tell you about another thing. I'll tell you another memory. I've never talked about this before on the air. My big sister was in the Girl Scouts. She's, I believe, 11 years older than me. I'm about 4 years old. I met this girl. No, I think she's 10 years older than me. I'm about 4 or 5 years old. I'm at the Girl Scout camp because my mom is the Girl Scout leader. They're at this camp. There's the sticks in my head like I can't believe to tell you. So there's all these tents, but the tents are on wooden fucking slats, right? It's nighttime. We're in the woods somewhere in Pennsylvania. And I'm in this thing with all these girls. They're teenagers. I'm around five. They're playing a stereo. And they play the song Satisfaction. And all the girls are up dancing. In wearing either just pajama tops, no pants. Or t-shirts, no pants. Or little nighties. And I'm sitting there, ass level, as a five-year-old, watching teenage girls dance to the song Satisfaction.
Wow.
They're spinning around. Their little shirts are coming up. Panties are flashing. And I say to myself, I've got to find out what this song is. And I need to play it for the rest of my life. So Satisfaction, to me, incredible song only because of that memory. And it did not make my top five.
Whoa. Oh.
Today.
Wow. Really thought I was going to be in there. That story and all.
You're building this up. I'm really interested.
But I will say this. If I ever open up a titty bar for five-year-old kids, but they have older girls dance for them. Now, by the way, when people act like, little kids aren't aware of sexuality, maybe I didn't know why that was a fucking fantastic thing, but my sister's friends dancing. I could tell you a couple other fucking times that I watched girls dance when I was a little kid. And then those fucking girls would like sometimes put me up on their lap or say that you were cute. And it was like amazing to me. It was like fucking perfect. You could have killed me at five and I would have been fucking okay with it. I just said, well, I've done some shit. Some stuff has happened. Nice. So I don't care. Ryan, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Midnight Rambler.
Midnight Rambler, the live version.
Yeah.
Is my number one.
Everybody got to. Well, I'm a talking about.
So that's my Stones. Today, Can't You Hear Me Knocking, Sway, Give Me Shelter, Sympathy, Midnight Rambler. It's not a perfect list. It's a solid list. But this list could easily be replaced with five different songs, and people would say, okay, that's an acceptable list. This is why it's fucking such a great band. X, what's something on my list that you'd pull out and something that you would replace it with?
I take out Sway, replace with Monkey Man.
Monkey Man's a great fucking song. I don't know why you got to shit all over fucking Sway, and I don't know why you got to shit all over Taylor. Let me hear you do one. What would you take out? What would you put in?
I would take out Sway. I'd put in Street Fighting Man.
You guys really need to fucking sit and listen to Sway a little more. I'm really fucking starting to... I don't know why they hate. Michael, I gave you the list. What would you take out and what would you replace it with?
Sway and Paint It Black.
All right, I am seriously might be quitting the show today for the fucking hate of Sway. Stalker Patty, you heard my list. What do you take out? What do you replace it with?
I don't know what I take out, but Coming Down Again, which is the third song on side one of Goat's Head Soup, is one of my favorite blues numbers of all time.
It is a very good song, isn't it?
It's an excellent song.
But you don't know what you would take out. You got to take something out, Patty. You take out Midnight Rambler?
You know what? Yeah, I'd take that out and put Coming Down Again. I like a little blues in there.
I know you do, honey. I know you do. John, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Yeah, how you doing, Ron? I'd take out, This Is Hard, too. Take out Gimme Shelter and put in there, if I could stick a knife in my heart, Suicide Right on the Stage. It's only rock and roll, man.
But I like it. Yes, I do. This is the fucking greatest band in the history of the world. I know why we got talking about this yesterday, because we were saying who was bigger when we were talking about when Jimmy went over who's the biggest fucking star and people that he wanted to have his picture taken with and blah blah blah. That's when I said I would do this. Then somebody wrote to me, Stones again, you're fucking filling time. Maybe. But I've been talking for the last 2 hours.
Hey, it's the five.
It's easy to blame Ronnie B, and I would too probably. I put all of the fucking weight on his shoulders.
No blames.
Here's Rich, I'm running Fez. What do you take out? What do you put in?
Ronnie. Yeah. Great show, man. Absolutely great. I can't take anything out, and anybody that doesn't get Sway has never been down the road that. A lot of this happened. I think you have to get it. And that's not, you know, right or wrong or good or bad. You're certainly not better off for going down that road. But to get it, I think you have to been down it. I got to go with Rocks Off, a song I never understood why it didn't get the big radio play. I'm happy it didn't because it's still, you know, it's still brilliant to me. But I agree with Jumpin' Jack Flash, too. That's one, somehow it never got stale. You always find a little nugget.
It is, you know what is fucking really true, too, is like, you hear that, and the fact that it got radio play, and then back to those twisted fucking lyrics, more twisted than anything in a metal fucking song, and you're like, well, people were dancing around to this in like fucking 66 or whatever, and it's about the most un-hippie stuff that you can imagine, but the fucking hippies loved them. Joe, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, another reason why they're the absolute best is they made a fucking country album, and it kicks ass.
Oh, I agree 100%. I love the shit, the country stuff that they do. I fucking love that stuff. That was actually some of the best shit ever. Let's go over to Doug. Doug, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, I guess I take out Gimme Shelter and put in Bitch, Ronnie.
Bitch was actually a good song, too. These are all fucking good tunes that come up. Brandon, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Number one has to be Gimme Shelter. And then number two, Midnight Rambler, Jigsaw Puzzle, Can't You Hear Me Knocking, and Sway.
All right, so you really have... Your biggest problem with me is just the order.
Just the order.
Yeah.
I love everything off of Let It Bleed. Can't go wrong with any track on that. You give props to Pepper with Monkey Man. But that's just the order it has to be.
It's really a great fucking song, too. Monkey Man's a great song. What did I, you know, I fucking said one day on the show with Dave, because he was all about Exile Main Street being the greatest album. And I was like, Sticky Fingers might be my fucking favorite album. And he was fucking freaking. But look at the songs on that fucking album. There's great songs on that. And G-Vac knew and already wrote in that I was going to pick Midnight Rambler. I hate the fact as my number one. All right, everybody wants to break it up now. Brazilian Julie has given her list.
Oh, my God.
Of favorite of them all. Pips has dropped to number 3 on her favorite of the interns. Nanami is number 2. And guess who's number 1 right now?
Yes, that would be me.
Yeah.
Wow.
And as she has said before, at the end of the term, who's ever number 1 gets to sleep with her.
Wow.
Could you imagine losing your virginity to her?
I could not, actually.
I will put an over-under with you 7 seconds. If you go over 7 seconds with her for your first time, I would be shocked.
Wow.
It's
a very long time.
Yeah. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Should I break before these guys? All right, we break.